Hey everyone, so in this video we're going to continue talking about graphics in the media. So starting with three-dimensional graphs. So three-dimensional graphs are pretty easy to do nowadays with computer software. Computer software very easily can give graphs a 3D appearance, which allows us to show a lot more data, because now not only can we have the years, we can have these different categories as well without having to just stack the bars next to each other. Because the more bars we stack next to each other, the more confusing it gets, because there's just a whole bunch of bars everywhere, hard to tell what's what anymore, right? So instead, the 3D makes it pretty easy to see what goes where, right? They can sometimes be kind of difficult to read, especially precisely, just because it's very hard to follow this over. If I just draw a straight line, it's at 5.5. But if we follow this line over, we can tell that it's less than 5. So it's hard to tell exactly where these bars are actually reaching. But they can get the job done to get some general ideas across. So for example, about when did China surpass Russia in total carbon dioxide emissions? So here's China, they're the yellow ones, and Russia is the blue. All right. So if we look at the yellow bars, then those rose really sharply, and the blue actually went down and then came back up a bit. So in this case, we can really easily tell that in 1990, the blue bar was definitely over the yellow bar. In 1995, the yellow bar was definitely over the blue bar. Right? So it was somewhere between 1990 and 1995. All right. Now, again, it makes it pretty easy to tell all the trends. You can tell the US, for example, steadily increased. You can tell China really increased. Russia went down but started to go back up. And Japan and India, Japan stayed fairly constant. India was barely increasing. So it does give a general sense about the data. But again, it's hard to tell precise values from this graph. All right, next up, a few cautions about graphics. So first off, we got perceptual distortions. So this is things that trick your mind into thinking that the numbers are different than they actually are. All right, so let's look at this first image. We can see that this graph is about twice as big as this one, right? So that makes it kind of look like, oh, the speed of his pitch, in this case, knuckleball, was twice as high as 2013. But that's not the case. If we look at the numbers, we actually see that there wasn't much of a difference. Right? It makes it look like a huge difference, but 75.3 is not half of 77.3. Right? It's only a 2 mile per hour difference. All right, so that can be misleading. Same thing in the second one. So the average house price in euros. So the title says that there's a massive increase in home price. And you see that in 1998, it was way down here. In 1999, it looks like it tripled. It's huge now, right? But if we look at the actual numbers, It went from 80,000 to 82,000. That's not actually a big increase. That's only a $2,000 increase. All right. Still an increase, sure, but it's not the three times that I was trying to make it look like. All right, next one. Under President Obama, more students are earning their high school diplomas than ever before. So, as you can see, we started out with only five books. And by the end, we end up with 16 books. Right? So, that must be a huge increase, right? But again, if we actually look at the numbers went from 75% to 82%. Oops. So that's a 7% increase. All right. It looks like there's three times as much because, wow. The books are so much higher. But in reality, the numbers weren't really three times as higher. It was just a small increase, but they do that to make it look a lot more. All right, next one. Watch the scales. All right. So let's compare these two graphs. These two graphs show exactly the same data. All right. It's 2007 and 2008, and it's the number of days of freezing temperatures. The graph on the left makes it look like this one's twice as big. Makes it look like there was twice as many days that had freezing temperatures. But in reality, this didn't start at zero. Notice how we jumped to 81 and went up through 85, but 0 through 80 just kind of disappeared. If we actually make this start at 0 and go all the way up, then you can tell that this change was extremely small. All right, it was actually only a 2-day increase. So extremely small. If we look at the next one, it's going to be the same exact thing. All right, the US unemployment rate. So if we look at the Clinton years and the Bush years, makes it look like Clinton had a way bigger unemployment rate during his time in office. But in reality, these numbers are really, really close. All right. They're actually only 0.02 off from each other. The reason for that is because we don't start at zero. We start at 5.175, right? That zooms in on this graph and it makes it look like this small change is actually really big. All right, sometimes though, there is a time where this can be really useful to have that scale like that. All right, so for example, this one is interest rates. So if we had the one on the right, it looks like the interest rates are staying the exact same. All right. But the one on the left does show that the interest rates are increasing, and they're increasing pretty fast. Right? Yes, these numbers are really, really small, but when you're dealing with something like interest rates, those really small differences actually do matter. Because a small change in the interest rate, depending on what you're doing, can end up with hundreds or thousands of dollars that you're paying more with interest. All right, and then last one. Women as a percentage of all college students. Again, if we look at the graph on the right, it barely even looks like there is a change. All right, because all of the data is centered between about 30 to 60-ish. So, if we zoom in on that 30 to 60, though, we can see that it's jumped around a lot. We can see how it went really down by 1950, but since then has went up to where now women are actually more than 50% of college students. And that's much easier to see since we did zoom in on it. All right, so just be careful with this because sometimes it is useful to zoom in and see data with a bigger change than it actually would look like otherwise. But media can use this to their advantage because if you see a bar graph that looks like this, then your mind automatically this just thinks this one's way higher. Right? Because your mind isn't actually looking at what the difference really is. We don't know if this is 100 and 300 or if this was 299 and 300. Right? They can put both of those data in those exact same bars. So just make sure you're paying attention to what the scale is so that you don't get tricked by this. Right? And that's going to be it for this video. There's going to be one more in this series looking at correlation. So I will see you in that video.